Deep sands and sandy duplexes feature throughout the millions of hectares of this medium to high rainfall region of WA's central wheatbelt. Additional productivity constraints can include non-wetting, compaction and poor fertility.
Deep sand, fairly shallow level of organic rich material at the surface and then pale below that.
Three local grower groups sought GRDC investment and support from Murdoch University to trial organic ameliorants that are readily sourced on farm, to include in growers' soil amendments approach.
We call it a waste product, so that could be either straw, old hay or manure that might be used from either a feedlot or come out of some of the sheep yards, cattle yards on property.
Three trial sites were chosen, Badgingarra, Corrigan and Wickapen, with mouldboarding used to incorporate the organic ameliorants into the predominantly non-wetting soils. After 3 years of trials, changes in soil health, crop productivity and return on grower investment are being assessed, with varying results so far.
So across the three sites, there hasn't been any clear return on investment for which treatments coming out on top. However, each individual site, there are a couple of treatments that are showing promise. For the Corrigan site, the high rates of manure are showing a lot of potential for increased profitability. And at the Wickapen site, the lower rates of manure have also shown promise. However, we still have one final season to analyse to determine if there's any clear treatment that has a return on investment for growers.
Murdoch University's Professor Richard Bell says at this stage of analysis, the absence of positive yield impacts from hay and from straw, which is known to provide potassium, might be explained by naturally varying compositions of organic materials, along with the time they can take to demonstrate improvements and boost productivity of sandy soils.
The best organic amendment is the one that's on the farm, because it's available and you have minimum transport costs associated with it. And we know that organic matter is important for soil function. So the question is, how might you improve organic matter in these sandy soils? What you're hoping though is that the amendment that you add kickstarts biomass production on the site, and that in itself starts to build a little bit more carbon, so you get this long-term boost from the amendment that you add.
The trial objective is to determine the value for WA's central wheatbelt growers to adopt some form of organic ameliorants into their sandy soils by 2024. And while these trials are designed to be applied to small and specific problem areas, rather than whole-of-farm issues, the trials have broad scope.
There are plenty of sands elsewhere in southern Australia, particularly South Australia and some into Victoria, so this work has some relevance there. But the broader message of boosting organic matter in soils for improved soil health, functionality and carbon sequestration is of general interest right across agriculture in Australia and worldwide indeed.
The Wickapen trial site belongs to grower Gary Lang, who's been seeking data-driven research around increasing his soil's productivity.
So we used chook manure, we used hay and we used straw. At this stage, chook manure has shown some result, but we've still got one more year of the trial to go, and the results will be interesting from that. We haven't seen a lot of change at this stage.
The researchers are now finalising their analysis of the three-year trial, with the anticipated data and knowledge base made possible by dedicated local networked growers who instigated this research program.
This is a good example of questions that have come from growers that have engaged three grower groups and situating experiments in different areas so that the information that comes out of it has local relevance.